So we're looking at a Frontenac vine here. This is on the midwire cordon system with vertical shoot positioning. A lot of people in the Midwest refer to it as the VSP system, but it is a training system with a cordon. And this is fairly typical for Frontenac on about any training system, where if we look in the middle of that vine, so where the cordons meet the trunk, we have much more aggressive canes than especially in the middle of the cordon. So in that middle cordon region, and a lot of cultivars, tends to be a little bit lower in vigor. And then at the ends of the cordons, we tend to have some better shoot and cane growth there as well. Now, one possible reasons why the yoke area is more aggressive than the ends of the cordon in some cases is grapevine trunk disease moving in, but in this situation, probably not. We have to be very conscientious about when we're pruning these vines, in that this yoke area in the middle, we want to make sure we don't just leave all of our canes we leave after pruning in that yoke area. We want to make sure we leave nice canes all along the base of that cordon. Now, that means in that yoke area, we'll probably have to be more aggressive at removing canes. And on the ends of these cordons, we have fewer to choose from, but we still have some decent ones. So if we're moving in here on this vine, and if we look in this area, we have, you know, maybe 10 good canes to choose from, if not more. And if this is a 1 foot area of the plant or more, we maybe only need to leave, you know, 3 of the best, something like that. Now, as we're moving down the vine here, you can see that we have lighter colored canes and more dieback in these canes. And again, the temptation is just to remove all those, but we have to be sure that we don't. We save some of the nicest ones possible, so we get some fruit there, so we get some shoot growth there to keep that part vigorous. Then as we go to the end of the cordon here, we get a little bit more vigor. And that's, again, fairly typical, where in the yoke area, there's a decent amount of vigor. And then as we get into the ends of the cordon, we tend to have a little bit more bump and vigor again. And again, we don't have as many canes to choose from as we did in that yoke area, but there's still several nice ones to choose from. Again, we got to be very conscientious. Even though there's fewer nice canes in the middle and the end of the cordon, we want to make sure we leave canes there after pruning and are a little more aggressive at thinning out this yoke area. And a common thing we see is leaving too much in this yoke area, because that's where all the nice canes are, but that just makes the situation worse and worse every year, where all that growth gets focused in that main area.